at the beauty, the different varieties here. We've got little miniature ones. We've got bigger ones. We've got all colors. I mean, really, they come in so many different ways. But here's the thing that happens. If you're feeling like you're killing your cyclamen, and many times they come, you receive them during the holidays in this pretty foil.
Yes, of course. Yeah.
Well, guess what? That, if you keep this on, that is the reason why your plant is done. The first thing you want to do when you have a cyclamen in foil, or actually any plant in foil,
take it out.
You remove it, because what happens is the water pools down here, and then it rots the roots of your plant.
Well,
now, what you want to remember about cyclamen is that it is a perennial plant. That means it can come back year after year. I think I said 30 years if you take good care of it.
Yeah.
Okay, so the thing is this. If you understand the life cycle of it, you are going to have this plant for a long time. So here's what happens. Because it has a little tuber, and I think we have a photo of the tuber, which is part of like a bulb. You see how nice that is? Tubers, bulbs, they have an interesting life cycle. So right now, we're in winter, but if you keep watering your cyclamen, it will continue to bloom all the way up until the beginning of summer, so through spring, when it starts getting warm, because it doesn't like warm weather. So when you get to that point, you stop watering completely. You induce dormancy, which is night-night time. You're going to see your plant wither. The leaves are going to turn yellow. It looks like it's dying. It's not dying. It wants to go to bed. So you could take off those leaves, put it in a, maybe leave it in its pot, put it in maybe the garage, a cool place. Let it sleep for 2 or 3 months.
Doesn't need sun.
No water, no nothing. You just leave it there.
As soon as you put water on it, which is what I want you to do in October, you're going to give life again to your plant. It's going to start growing leaves, green leaves, and then through fall. And then in the winter, you're going to have the beautiful display.
You could put it in the basement.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good idea, because it's cool.
Cooled out in the basement. Sure.
So if you see
that. Here's the dilemma. When you say, oh, I water my plant all the time.
Yes.
Well, guess what? You're watering it too much if the leaves start turning yellow. I mean, look, everything is upright. It's not droopy. So it's not underwater. It's overwatering. So when you water it, you want to water it on the soil. You don't want to water the leaves. You don't want to water the flowers. It's right there. Let it drain. And then the water that pools in the saucer, get rid of it. It will not, it will rot. Look at this little sad puppy. Now this is the example of underwatering, where it droops. And what's going to happen is if you don't water it, it's going to think it's dormancy time.
But it's not dead.
It's not dead. You can still rectify this. You can fix it. Yeah. But you got to water it thoroughly.
That's
and then just let it drain. And then start, do no more harm. They are harmful to pets, guys. Keep this off the floor. It could, it is toxic to them, but you need to water them when the soil feels dry. I'm not talking bone dry like this.
Okay.
This is too dry. So it might not be that often, okay? And then you want to place it in the coolest room of your house. They don't like 70 degrees. 50 to 60 degrees,
so
most of the ones we receive for Christmas gifts, they're the kind that are indoor. They're cultivated in a greenhouse. And so this, water only when dry, put it not in a window, because then it's going to cook. It doesn't want it, but it wants a bright room, okay?
Yeah.
And so that's basically it. The right placement, right temperatures, and, water it as needed. And you can keep it alive.